Hello everyone, welcome to lesson 70 of our Colang course. In this lesson, we are going to focus our attention on the co-scheduler, which is responsible for managing the goroutines. So let's get started. Every Go program has at least one goroutine, which is the main goroutine. But creating more goroutines is very easy. As you have seen in previous examples, you can start a goroutine with the Go keyword. It accepts a function to run concurrently. This function could be a regular function, a method, anonymous function, or a function stored in a variable. To understand goroutines and remove the confusion, let us first understand how concurrency traditionally works. First, let us start with threads. Threads are a fundamental concept in computer science for achieving concurrency. A thread is a single sequence of instructions that can be executed concurrently with other threads. For example, a single CPU core is a worker. Threads are like individual tasks assigned to that worker. The CPU can switch between these tasks rapidly, creating an illusion of them running simultaneously. The switching of threads is done with the help of context switching, which is an expensive task, as it requires to move data out of CPU cache to put the new thread-related data in the CPU cache. Threads belong to a process, which is an instance of a program running on the system. A process encapsulates resources like memory and open files. Within a process, you can have multiple threads working together on different parts of the program. The operating system is responsible for managing threads. It creates, schedules, and destroys threads, deciding when each thread gets a turn to use the CPU. So, the scheduling of threads is managed by the OS itself. Then we have the green threads. Green threads are type of threads that are managed by the program runtime environment, like a virtual machine, instead of the operating system itself. So the program is responsible for managing and scheduling the green threads. As we have seen, threads are managed by the operating system kernel, which is the core of the system. Green threads, on the other hand, are managed at the user level by the program's runtime. Green threads are lightweight compared to the traditional thread. This allows for creating many more without significant resource overhead. Traditionally, the threads managed by the operating system are preemptive, meaning the operating system can control and switch between threads at any time. Green threads, however, are cooperative. They rely on the program itself to decide when to switch between them. In earlier versions of Java, green threads were used for concurrent programming. Then there are coroutines. Coroutines are a general concept in computer science that provide a way to structure code for cooperative multitasking. Code does not use threads or green thread, it uses coroutines. And that is where the name coroutines comes from. Coroutines too are cooperative. Unlike threads, which can be switched between by the operating system at any time, coroutines rely on cooperation to manage their execution. They voluntarily yield control back to the main program and can be resumed later. Think of it like taking turns on a playground slide. Threads would be like a kid being pushed down by an adult regardless of their turn, while coroutines are like kids taking turns themselves. Coroutines are lightweight compared to the traditional threads. They have a smaller memory footprint, making it possible to create many of them without overwhelming the system. Coroutines are designed to be building blocks for writing well-structured concurrent programs. They allow you to define units of work that can be paused and resumed at any specific point. Here are some key benefits of using coroutines, or in our case, goroutines. It has a simpler concurrency model. Coroutines can make it easier to write code that execute concurrently without the complexity of managing the low-level threads directly. By relying on cooperative scheduling and avoiding shared memory access issue common with threads, coroutines can help reduce errors in a concurrent program. Coroutines can easily be nested and combined to create a complex concurrent workflow. As we have already discussed, Go's coroutines are a type of coroutine. The goroutines in Go are specific implementation of coroutines that are managed by the Go runtime. They offer advantages like being lightweight, efficiently scheduled, and promoting communication through channels. Now let us focus our attention on the Go scheduler. The Go Runtime built-in scheduler takes the burden of managing Go routines off your shoulders. Let's explore how this simplifies things with an illustrative example. Traditionally, this is how concurrency is run. You have a core, then you have two threads running, thread 1 and thread 2. Now first, the OS will give thread 1 the chance to run on it. So it is processing. When it wants to talk to thread 2, that means thread 2 should now run on the core. So the OS will perform context switching and move to thread 2 while thread 1 is on hold. So thread 2 proceeds with the data from thread 1 and starts processing. When this is done, it will send back data to thread 1. Now it's time for thread 1 to start executing. As such, thread 2 is now paused and thread 1 is resumed. So the switching between thread 1 and thread 2 is done with context switching, which again can be expensive. Now let us look at what the Go scheduler does. So as you can see, we have a core here and we have a single thread. Now Go routines are queued into a queue. As you can see, 1, 2, 3 are all Go routines. When the scheduler wants to execute Go routine 1, it will use thread 1 to execute it, while 2, 3, 4 are waiting. If goroutine 1 becomes blocking, it can put it aside and keep running it on thread 1. Then the scheduler will create thread 2 to execute the rest of the goroutines. Once goroutine 1 completes, it comes back to the queue and thread 1 is kept on hold for future processing, while the scheduler will keep processing all the goroutines on thread 2. So imagine the Go scheduler as a conductor for an orchestra. It maintains a queue of coroutines, like musicians, waiting for their turn. However, instead of assigning each coroutine to a separate instrument or a thread, the scheduler maps a specific number of coroutines to a smaller number of threads. It's important to note that smaller number of threads help maintain a performant concurrent system, because if you have a load of threads, CPU would have to perform context switching to give each thread an opportunity to run on the core. And as mentioned earlier, context switching is expensive, which could deteriorate the performance of the program. So as we talked in this lesson, the Go scheduler strikes a clever balance to optimize performance. It typically tries to maintain the number of threads equal to the logical processing cores available on your system. This ensures efficient utilization of hardware resources, as this means there will be very less number of context switching between the threads. More importantly, the scheduler aims to hold on to OS threads once it acquires them. Instead of releasing a thread after a single Go routine finishes, it strategically schedules a waiting Go routine to take over the same thread. This minimizes the expensive context switches and keeps things running smoothly. So this is the basic model of concurrency in Go, which is achieved with a very clever Go scheduler that maintains the Go routines. That's it for the lesson. I hope you enjoyed it. If you have any questions, please post a comment under the video or reach out to our Discord server. Until next time, happy coding.